greeting to all from psychology and educational psychology. Today we will discuss about meaning and definitions of the psychology and what is the difference between science and behavior, because science is different concept, behavior is a different concept. So we need to understand what is science and what is behavior. So let us discuss about the meaning of the psychology. The word psychology is derived from two Greek words, psycho and logi. So how many words are there? Psycho and logi. Psycho means soul, and science means logi means science. So already you know that we cannot see, we cannot touch the soul. But thus, in the beginning of the psychology, was believed to be the science of the soul. The definition of the psychology was the science of the soul. Psychology is nothing but the science of the soul. This definition was popular among the people when psychology was studied as a sub branch of philosophy. Already you know that previously psychology was study of the sub branch of the philosophy. Next, psychology, when a psychology as an independent discipline acquired separate status very recently from the philosophy. So that's why, since the nature of soul could not be defined in terms, this meaning of psychology means the science of the soul definition was opposed by contemporary philosophers. Those who are philosophers at that time, number of philosophers were rejected this definition. At that time, philosophers evolved another definition of psychology, saying that psychology is the science of mind. The second definition was accepted by the people for a very long time. Then again, the same controversy arose regarding the nature of mind and its definitions, and ultimately this definition too was discarded by the philosophers. So here, discarded means what? Rejected by the most number of philosophers. Initially, this definition was accepted by the number of people for a long period of time. But after a long period of time, same controversy aroused again. Number of people were rejected this definition. In the third phase, the attention of philosophers shifted from thinking to action. There is a lot of difference between thinking and action. So you cannot observe, you cannot touch thinking, but you can observe and also you can touch action also. So that's why action is going to take place in a realistic manner. Thinking is going to take place in unrealistic manner. So man engages himself in a number of activities from morning to till evening. He is conscious why he is doing a particular activity and how is this activity governed by a mind. In our daily life also, we are going to do number of activities, but whatever activity we are going to do, in whatever activity we are going to participate, we are going to participate in a conscious manner. Conscious manner means with intention, in a knowing manner. Yes or no? So thus, philosophers defined psychology as a science of conscious or immediate experience. So here, what is the third definition? Whatever immediate experiences we are going to get, whatever conscious areas are going to be there. So here we are going to, psychology is going to study about consciousness or immediate experiences. But later, on this definition was rejected by the psychologists on the ground that consciousness is only a small portion of total personality of human beings. You cannot identify, you cannot understand the complete behavior of human beings by only concentrating on the conscious experiences of the human being. Behaviors are conscious, subconscious, and unconscious all. Thus, we cannot study an individual just by observing his conscious activities only. If you want to study an individual in a complete manner, it is not possible by only concentrating on the conscious activities. So this last definition led to the beginning of experimental psychology, and psychology was made an independent discipline free from philosophy. After this definition only, psychology was made an independent discipline free from philosophy. So thus, pure psychologists defined psychology as a science of behavior. So this is the exact definition or correct definition of psychology. In order to know that what psychology actually is, we must analyze these two concepts, science and behavior, in a separate manner. If you want to understand actually what is a psychology, you need to understand the concept of science and the concept of behavior. So you need to understand these two concepts. What are these two concepts? One is a science and other one is behavior. So when you understand what is science and what is behavior, then only you can understand what is psychology in a comprehensive manner. Now let us discuss about the concept of science. Science is a systematic study of knowledge which may be verified at any time by any number of individuals under given conditions. So thus, knowledge obtained by science is not subjective, it is rather objective. So already you know that science is nothing but it is a systematic study of knowledge. Whatever you want to learn, which is available in the nature, which is available in the laboratory, so there you are going to study science in a systematic manner. Yes or no? Next, second one, in any condition you can learn science in a systematic manner. Why? Means science is going to take place in actual manner, in a realistic manner, and for whatever science is available in the nature, so for each and every science, what is there? Truth is there, proof is there, evidence is there, right? So here, thus knowledge obtained by science is not subjective, it is rather objective. Do you know what is the difference between subjective and objective? Subjective means science is not a subjective. Why? Means whatever is available in the nature, you are going to explain as it is. You are not going to add your personal opinion on science or on the nature. As it is, you are going to tell. As it is, you are going to explain. You are not going to add any masala. So that's why it is not a subjective. When it is a subjective, then it is not a science. So that's why science is not subjective. Why? Means in science, we cannot add any our personal feelings, opinions, because whatever is available in the science, whatever is available in the nature, you are going to explain, you are going to do the presentation, and you are going to tell as it is. So that's why it is not subjective, it is rather objective. Why it is rather objective? Whatever objective is written by you, you are going to achieve that objective either by doing an observation or by doing an experimentation. right? So here let us discuss about characteristics of science or scientific study. First one, it is the process of discovery of truth, and this truth can be objectively verified. What is the science? Science is the process of discovery of truth. You know that nowadays even for corona also they are doing a research to prepare a vaccine. Yes or no? Why? Because the disease, a corona, is science. Because what is available? Proof is available, truth is available, evidence is available. When evidence is available, when truth is available, then there is a possibility to prepare a vaccine for corona. So already you know that number of vaccines are coming across the world. Yes sir. Next, second one, scientific statements are general and systematic. They are put in a systematic order depending on the objectives of research. So thus scientific study is all the time research study. Means that whatever scientific statements we are going to prepare, those statements are general and also in a systematic manner. After giving statement in a scientific manner with respect of science on same topic, there is a possibility of doing a research. Yes sir. Because whenever we are going to do research on any area related to the science, related to the nature, related to the diseases, so there first we are going to prepare objectives, research objectives. By concentrating on the research objectives only, you are going to do the research, you are going to do the experimentation, and you are going to do the discovery of scientific generalization or scientific law. Next, third one, for the purpose of reaching truth in science, data are first collected by observation and experimentation, then these data are interpreted keeping in view the research objectives and hypothesis. Finally, definite conclusions are drawn by using reflective thinking. So here, for the purpose of, for example, you just want to reach to know the truth in science. For that purpose, what you are going to do? There is a problem in a science, there is a research area in a science. To know the conclusion of that topic, to know the conclusion of that problem, to know the final conclusion of that problem, what you are going to do? You are going to collect data. In which way you are going to collect data? Either by using an observation or by doing an experimentation, you are going to collect data. Yes or no? After collecting data by using observation method and by using an experimentation method, then you are going to interpret, you are going to analyze what is right and what is wrong. After doing, when you are going to do the analysis of the data, when you are going to do the interpretation of the data, your concentration is on research objectives. Why means? Before going to do research on any area, first you are going to write a research objectives. After writing a research objectives only, you are going to collect data by using observation and experimentation. Then you are going to do the analysis or interpretation of that data by concentrating on objectives and hypothesis. So here, objectives means what? Hypothesis means what? Before going to do research on any area, what you are going to achieve, what you want to achieve, by concentrating on that area, you are going to write hypothesis, you are going to write objectives. So finally, after interpretation of the data, after analysis of the data, by concentrating on research objectives and hypothesis, then you are going to draw conclusion in a definite manner by using the process of reflective thinking. Yes sir. Next one, the inference drawn from the researches are put in the form of certain laws. So these laws are so solid that they can predict about future course of action also. After collecting a conclusion, after collecting a data, you are going to do the conclusion, you are going to prepare the conclusion, you are going to prepare the final report. So whatever final conclusion is there, so that final conclusion is going to transform into law. It is going to transform into law. After transforming that conclusion into law, then what you are going to do in future also, you are going to predict. In future also, you are going to predict what actually is going to take place. Okay. And the last one, scientific laws can be applied to real life situation, or they can be used to understand the life itself. Means that, for example, in science, for example, we have a proof or an evidence. Already you know that plants are going to prepare the food by using the process of a photosynthesis. Yes or no? Yes, 100% plants are going to prepare the food by using the process of a photosynthesis. How you can prove? In a laboratory, at our home also, we can prove that yes, plants can prepare food by using the process of photosynthesis by taking the support of leaves. Yes sir. So this is a law. Yes sir. This is a scientific law. So this scientific law we can apply in a real life situation also. In real life situation, we are doing agriculture. In agriculture, we are farming different vegetables, different fruit items. Why? Because we know that plants can prepare food by using the process of photosynthesis. By using this scientific law, we are farming agriculture in a different sectors. Yes, sir. So that's why whatever scientific laws we are going to draw, so these scientific laws we can able to apply in a real life such situation for the purpose of knowing whether it is right or wrong. Next concept is behavior. So after understanding the concept of science, we need to understand behavior. Then only we can able to understand psychology in a comprehensive manner. The term behavior was popularized by an American psychologist, J.B. Watson. So already you know that J.B. Watson is one of the famous American psychologists who is going to concentrate completely on behavior of the both human beings and also animals. So he defined behavior as an action which can be seen and observed in an objective way. In our day-to-day life, both animals and also human beings are going to behave in a different manner. We are going to participate in a different action. So every action can be seen and also observed. Yes or no? In an objective way. Yes or no? Why? Because behavior is nothing but which we are going to use in a real life situation. Whenever you are going to live your life, till the end of your life, you are going to expose your behavior depending upon the situation, depending upon the condition. So this meaning of behavior includes external and internal stimulations both. To use your behavior in a different situations, both external and internal issues are going to play an important role. Yes or no? Because exposition of behavior, exploration of behavior is going to depends upon both internal and also external stimulation. Then stimulation means what? Stimulation is nothing but motivation. Yes sir. For example, if anybody will ask, can you sing a song? If you have internal stimulation, and external stimulation, then only you are going to sing a song. Only external motivation is there, external stimulation is there, there is no internal stimulation, then you are not going to sing a song. Thus, human behavior can be measured objectively according to this definition of behavior. Whatever is there in our conscious, unconscious or subconscious mind is reflected by our behavior at proper stimulus. Already you know that behavior means what? Conscious behavior, unconscious behavior, subconscious behavior, conscious mind, unconscious mind, subconscious mind. Yes or no? So whenever you are going to expose your behavior there, in that behavior, conscious mind is going to be reflect, unconscious mind is going to reflect, subconscious mind is also going to reflect. So that's why, so here, greater part of the behavior can be observable in an easy manner. Only little bit, little part of behavior we cannot able to observe. So that's why understanding behavior is nothing but understanding psychology. Understanding science is nothing but understanding psychology. The combination of science and behavior is going to be called as a psychology. So that's why we need to understand. Can you expect that in each and every situation, you are going to use the same behavior? Depending upon the need, depending upon the condition, depending upon the importance of that area, you are going to use your behavior in a situational manner. So that's why in our daily life, psychology is going to play an important role. So this is the topic, meaning of a psychology, definitions of the psychology, and what is the concept of science and behavior. Thank you.